हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग. आई एम डॉक्टर श्रीकांत अपसानी, मेडिकल गैस्ट्रोएंटरोलॉजिस्ट, थेरापेटिक एडवांस्ड इंटरवेंशनलिस्ट, किम्स हॉस्पिटल, सिकंदराबाद. टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एंडोस्कोपिक ट्रीटमेंट्स फॉर अर्ली जीए कैंसर्स लाइक एंडोस्कोपिक सबम्यूकोसल डिसेक्शन ESD, स्टर, सबम्यूकोसल टनलिंग एंडोस्कोपिक रिसेक्शन एंड EMR. Endoscopic mucosal resections. We all come across various lesions on endoscopy. Most of these patients would have come to us with simple gastric issues or some bleeding in the colon, etc. We get an endoscopy done and a colonoscopy done, and we find early tumors. In fact, with the advance of this endoscopic treatments, we have actually avoided major surgeries if we treat these patients at the early stage. Like for example, if the disease has not spread beyond the intestine, then we can offer them endoscopic treatment. That is, we can remove the tumor completely with the help of endoscopy. The surgeons call it as R0 resection. That means the margins are completely free of the tumor. With this advanced third space endoscopy, we also can achieve R0 endoscopic resection. So what is this procedure about? Before that, I will just briefly tell you what our intestine actually looks like from the third space perspective. We have four layers: the inner mucosa, submucosa, the muscle, and the serosa covering it. Now what we are actually doing is we are trying to separate this mucosa from the underlying muscle by creating either a space between these two in the form of a submucosal tunnel or fiber by fiber separation from the underlying muscle and dissecting the tumor completely away from the underlying base and then coming out. So these procedures help in preventing the removal of the intestine completely. Now, first we'll go to the procedure which is known as EMR, endoscopic mucosal resection. What we essentially do in this, we find small polyps, and the polyps can have small cancers also, or we find some flat lesions. Flat lesions are ulcerated lesions which are above the mucosal level, and then they are depressed in sometimes in the center. These lesions can be elevated with the help of some injection going between the muscle and the mucosa, and we can apply a snare and completely remove it either once or in small bits and pieces. This is what we call as endoscopic mucosal resection. Now, instead of removing it blindly, suppose we take a small knife, we call it as an IT knife, we call it hybrid knife, we have separate endoscopic knives where we slowly chop this mucosa, we separate it from the underlying submucosa and the muscle with the help of these special knives, and then we circumferentially dissect it layer by layer and completely remove this lesion into it. It is not a blind procedure, it is a very fine dissection where we separate it layer by layer and then we completely remove the tumor. This is known as the ESD, endoscopic submucosal dissection. Sometimes we have a submucosal tumor, that is, tumor is somewhere between the mucosa and the muscle, or sometimes in the muscle where the mucosa is completely covered. This is commonly for cases like gastrointestinal stromal tumors. So these tumors can be removed endoscopically also. We call it as STER, submucosal tunneling endoscopic resection. What is this? We actually enter the food pipe or the stomach somewhere behind this tumor. We create a tunnel between the muscle and the mucosa. We go to the tumor, dissect the tumor completely, remove it out, and then wherever we have entered the mucosa, we close it with the help of clips. Again, this avoids a major surgery and this can be done endoscopically. Most of these procedures take around 1 to 2 hours depending upon the size of the lesion. And the biggest advantage is the patient can be discharged on the very next day. It's just a single daycare admission requiring 24 hours of hospitalization. The second advantage is the patient doesn't need a major surgery and we can have the organ preservation. The third advantage is that the anesthetic risks are very minimal because we'll be doing it under propofol sedation or max a simple amount of general anesthesia. How does this special endoscopic treatments help the patients? This treatments can help the patient only if they're referred early. Like for example, the gastroenterologist or the surgeon or the physician has got an endoscopy or a colonoscopy done and they finds a lesion which is looking like a tumor or a cancer. If they are referred early, then we can do our special tests and see if it has not spread out. We can actually go and do an endoscopic resection. So the main important message which I would like to tell is, if there are some tumorous lesions which are found, please do send them early so that before they spread to the surrounding organs, we can actually do a complete endoscopic removal and help the patients in going ahead with a simple procedure rather than a complicated surgery. Thank you.